Hey there, guys, it's Tina, and I'm back. And I hope you guys are all doing well and staying safe. If you're also back, welcome back. Thank you so much for joining me again. But if you're new and maybe you like what you see, which, you know what, I might be judging you a little bit if you like what you see in this video, but if you like what you see and maybe you enjoy beauty and makeup content, then feel free to hit the subscribe button and join the fancy fam, because we have tons of fun here on this channel talking about makeup and all things beauty. So in today's video, I'm gonna take you guys on a journey with me, okay? This was a very spontaneous journey, and one that, you're just gonna have to wait to see what happens, but I am going to set it up for you. Let me set the stage. So I am currently back from vacation, but this was filmed before I went on vacation, because as you do when you're prepping for vacation, you go get your nails done, probably do a gel polish, probably do your lashes and your hair, and sometimes, just sometimes, you may want to go ahead and tint your brows. Now, I've never ever tinted my brows before, but for some reason, I figured it would be a good idea to try tinting my brows this time around. I was going on a long vacation. I didn't want to be bothered with filling in my brows every day. So I had the bright idea to go ahead and tint my brows, even though I've never done it before, but I've seen people do it and have such great results. And I'm like, that would be perfect for vacation. I don't have to worry about my brows each and every day. That would be fantastic. So that is the journey that I'm about to take you guys on. I am going to tint my brows for the very first time, and I'm gonna show you my results. And plot twist, things went a little awry, but I'm not gonna spoil it for you. You're just gonna have to watch and see. So if that sounds like something interesting to you, let's go ahead and jump right into it. All right, so I'm a little bit nervous, I'm going to admit it. I've never tinted my brows before, and I feel a little bit reckless doing this for the first time when I'm going on a trip. So if they're totally messed up, like I'm screwed, but we're gonna try it. You know what? I color my hair myself, and I feel pretty confident in my abilities. I'm saying this, I probably just jinxed myself. Oh my God, but we're gonna try it out. So I grabbed the Parallel Products Premium Spot Color Henna in Deep Dark Brown. I got this from Amazon. It just comes in a little bottle like this, and they say a little bit goes a long way, so I'm a little bit nervous, but we're gonna go for it. It comes with a little mixing cup, but that's about it. So you're supposed to pour some of this powder into the cup, add water until you get a yogurt texture is what they say, and then apply it to your brows and leave it on for maybe 10 minutes. I'm gonna double check, hold on. That's not what it says. It says to let the henna sit for 10 minutes after mixing it to fully develop and then apply it to the brows. Then once it's on, then you're supposed to wait 10 to 15 minutes to let it sit. And here's the part that's getting me right now. Dye will continue to darken for 4 to 7 days after initial application. I don't know how I feel about that. So wish me luck, because I'm definitely going to apply product within 24 to 48 hours, because I still want to film some videos before I leave. And that 4 to 7 days is making me a little bit nervous, because I don't want it to darken. So I'm just gonna leave it on for a short time to be safe, because I don't want super dark brows at all. And I just poured a little of the powder into the mixing jar, and now I'm going to add water. So they don't give you a spoolie or anything, so you have to use your own, which I have spoolie, so I should be fine. And I have a little dropper with water and a little orange stick, mixing it up. Okay, it's a little bit yogurty. It's almost foaming, it's bubbling a bit. This is what it looks like. It's not runny, it's like a thick mousse texture. It's kind of like yogurt, I would say. So I'm gonna let this sit for 10 minutes and then we're gonna apply it. All right, it's been over 10 minutes actually, which makes me a little bit nervous, but I'm still going to go for it. Whew. I'm going to use the thinnest angled brush that I have and apply this product. I'm feeling like, oh no, oh no, oh Lord. All right, let's just go, okay? So I'm going to brush this just through, the brow hairs directly, right? All right. Where I normally would create my shape. I'm going to try to stay just on the hair itself and not go over onto my skin. So it's kind of just darkening up my actual brow hairs in the shape that I would normally fill them in. Low key, I am not even being that careful. Maybe I should be a little bit more careful. Dear Jesus, oh my God. All right, let me darken up the arch where I definitely fill in all the time. Little bit nervous, not gonna lie. Darken up the arch, okay. I think that's good. Let me add just a little bit more. Right here. Ooh, we made a mess. Hold on. Not to fair, I have really tiny cotton swabs. Let me just get some alcohol on that and clean up the edge. Okay, I think that's good. I'm kind of happy with that. Let me put a little bit on the lower part of my brow. This part is making me nervous because I might not fill in all that way. All right. I think that's good. I'm gonna wipe off the excess and just do like some light strokes through the start of my brow. I'm feeling like that's good. I'm feeling confident. Y'all, what if this comes out looking a hot mess? What are you gonna, like, oh my God. Cause this is actual henna, right? Oh crap. Now I'm rethinking things. All right, I think that looks fine. Let me brush it through just a little bit and clean up. Woo! All right, I'm gonna do the other side quietly because I'm nervous. I am so nervous. This is the one that usually gets thick. This brow usually gets too thick. So I definitely need to just stay on the brow hairs and be very precise. I think I'm pretty happy with that. Maybe I should be a little bit more nervous because it hasn't dried down yet. Oh my God. All right, I think I'm pretty much done here. Let me try to do some spoolieing right here just to lighten up some situations. Yeah, let me just fade out the start of my brow so it doesn't look so harsh. I think I should stop while I'm ahead. What do you think? Like, I'm just like, stop. Stop right now while you are ahead so you don't completely go overboard and mess them up. Okay, let me just, oh my God, y'all. I am going to stop now and let it sit for 15 to 20 minutes. Apply warm water, soft cotton pad, and wash it off. All right, I'll see you guys in 10 to 15 minutes. Oh my God, I'm so nervous. I am so nervous. Okay, y'all, it's been over 10 minutes and I'm a little bit nervous. Ready for the reveal? I have paper towel and warm water. So, let's go for it. It's coming off. That's a good sign. All right. Ooh, yeah, that's a lot. I'm gonna need more paper towel. But they just said to wipe it off, right? With the gently wash away the henna mixture. Ooh. gonna get some more paper towel. Hold up. More paper towel. Let's just wipe that off. Gently. Gently, they said. Okay. Next side. Ooh, y'all. This. Oh my god. Oh my. Oh wow. Y'all, I was very nervous about this whole situation, and I'm still a little bit nervous about what's going to happen in the next 4 to 7 days because it's supposed to darken. But this looks freaking good. Stop it right now. This looks so good. Oh my god. Separate paper towel to dry. Pat dry, they said. Oh my god. Wow. Oh wow. Oh wow. Oh my god. It really looks like my brows are filled in. Wow, this looks, y'all, this looks so good. This looks so darn good. This brow looks a lot better. It usually does though. But this one looks so much better than this one. Oh my god. I think I might go in and touch this one up a little bit. What do you think? Should, because this one looks like really extended and beautiful, and then this one looks like a little stumpy. Should I go and try to extend this one a little bit? I am going to do it and show you the results. So we're gonna do the same process, only I'm gonna focus a little bit more on this brow, and then I'll show you what it looks like. But this one looks so good. Oh my god, this one looks so good. I am so impressed with how this one looks right now. I am so happy because I can literally just walk out the door with this brow. Oh my god. All right, I'm gonna redo this one. I'll be back. Hold up. Wait a damn minute, y'all. These are the results. So I extended the tail on this one so it kind of matches up. They're not perfect, but aren't they amazing? Look at it. Looks like I filled my brows in. My only worry is, is this really going to darken? Because that may be a little bit of an issue if they darken a lot. But so far, they look exactly how I would fill in my brows. So I am happy with the results. I am going to check in tomorrow with you guys to see how they develop overnight. And I'll keep on checking in for the next couple of days just to show you the results. So consider this day one. This is the initial application. I already washed my face, so I am not going to apply anything to my face tonight. I'm just going to let them sit and marinate, and we will see what they look like in 24 hours. Y'all, we have a situation, all right? So it's day two of my henna tinted brows, and I am a little bit in agony. First of all right, the brows got darker overnight, which is what I was expecting. I was anticipating and kind of fearing, right, that it was gonna get dark as hell. But not only did they get darker, Can you see anything that's happening? My brows are irritated as hell. Oh my god, I should have done a patch test. Like, they always say do a patch test to see if you have a reaction. And I am currently having a reaction. Oh my god, my brows are itchy. And I don't want to get too scratch happy. But they are itchy. And the skin under and around my brows is slightly swollen. So, I don't know if you can tell. Like, it's raised a little bit. You probably can't tell, but I can tell, like, there's irritation. Like, my brows look red. And that is not the color of the henna. That is literally my brows being very angry. It's, like, violently angry. And I don't know what to do. I am going to put some Benadryl cream on the brows. I don't mind if they fade a little bit because, like I said, they're dark. They do look good. Like, I like the result. However, the red is not gonna work at all. Like,
Do you see, like, doesn't my skin look angry? Oh my God, so this is day two. This is my check-in showing you what is happening. I am fine as far as the shape goes, how they look, like I can go outside. I'm happy with the actual result. But right now, my skin isn't happy. So day two, not a happy camper, but I'm going to power through because I have no choice, really. I'm gonna put some Benadryl cream on and I'll let you know if that helped at all, but this is my first check-in. Y'all, this is check-in number three, so I'm on my third day and my eyes are swollen. Oh my God. I woke up this morning like, why does my eye feel like that? My eyes are completely swollen. Like, look at this one. Like, look at what is happening? Oh my God, I am laughing, but I'm really nervous right now because I leave the country tomorrow. I have a 24-hour travel day tomorrow, and my eyes look like this. Like, I don't... No, don't laugh. It's not funny. Oh my God. No, like, for real though. I am being optimistic. I am gonna be really optimistic right now. I am hoping this will go down today. It has to. It has to. I'm gonna take some Benadryl, try to sleep because this shouldn't be happening. And the thing is, I need to braid my hair today. So I don't know like what's gonna happen right now, but this is not fun. And my eyebrows are throbbing. So they're swollen as well, still red around the area that I have the henna, but my concern is, right, the henna is obviously causing an allergic reaction, right? But it's gonna take days for it to fade. So is it also gonna take like days for this to go down, or will this go down today? I don't know. If I take the Benadryl and that doesn't help, I'll probably have to go to the ER or like urgent care because I'm gonna need to get allergy medicine that's probably stronger than Benadryl, you know what I mean? And yeah, an EpiPen would be great because, you know, I think they can give you an allergy shot. So if it does get worse, that's what I'll do. So I can't travel like this. No, it's not fucking funny. Like, y'all, I need evidence of what is happening right now. Look at my eyes. This one is extremely swollen towards the inner eye as well. So it's like barely opening. This one is not that bad because it's like swollen right above my eye. So like my eye still opens fully, but this one, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? I'm gonna have to probably get, yeah, an allergy shot or something because this ain't helping. But the brows look fine. They look fine. Was it worth it? I'll tell you right now, no, it was not. And I've washed my face, I've washed my brows, like I've gone in and the henna has faded a bit, like the actual henna in my brows has faded. But my skin is still red and I am swollen. So lesson learned, never doing this again, at least not with that product. But this is the situation we're dealing with, day three. Y'all, talk about having bad luck. It has gotten worse, okay? So don't laugh, do not laugh. Like, it's not painful, so don't cry for me, Argentina. I'm not in pain. And my brows, like right around my brows, are just slightly itchy. So it's not like crazy uncomfortable. It's just that... No, I need to document this for future generations. But like, seriously, this eye is so swollen. I probably have all kinds of eye boogers. But this eye is extremely swollen. Like, do you guys see that? It's really swollen and puffy, and I can barely open it. This eye is getting more and more swollen, and the area feels a little warm, but it's not burning and itching and anything crazy. Like, it doesn't feel severely uncomfortable. It's just the swelling. I just went to urgent care because I have a flight to catch tomorrow. It's my birthday on Monday. Like, what the fuck, right? So I got a steroid shot. I asked for that. They asked me if I wanted to get a steroid shot. Yes. Stick me in my butt, okay? Because I'm ready to go on my flight. I cannot have this. So I got a steroid shot, which they do in your behind. And then I got prescribed prednisone. And I'm going to take that. And they also prescribed Zyrtec. So hopefully this goes down by tomorrow. Because this... it's not cute. Like, I look crazy. I look crazy. And I need this to go down so I can have a good trip for my birthday. So it is what it is, but this is what I'm dealing with.
All right, so it's still day three and I had to go to urgent care, get a steroid shot in my butt, and now I have oral steroids to take for the next 4 days. And they also told me to get Zyrtec because this situation. So here is what we have right now. It feels like it's getting a little bit better, but really the swelling hasn't gone down. This eye is the worst for wear, but it's fine. It's fine. We're gonna be fine. This one is swollen. You can see it right here. Like, you see the lid is swollen, but this is the one that even my inner tear duct, it feels tickly because it's swollen. So it's, you know, but I feel like it's getting a little bit better. So hopefully by the morning, we're in better shape, because this morning I was just like, I can't, okay, because I have a flight tomorrow. So I'm gonna braid my hair right now. So this is my hair blown out, okay? And I am ready to do the braiding. One day I will film me braiding my hair. I was gonna do it this time around, but it's just short notice. I don't have time. I didn't expect to have to be at urgent care today. I was going to film the braiding today, but honestly, it didn't happen because this situation happened instead. So this is day three. I will update you guys tomorrow and let you know what it looks like, but not fun. It has not been fun. There is something in that henna dye that I used. I know there's a banned ingredient, but I thought they banned the ingredient, so these products shouldn't have it anymore. But there's something in there. I'll do the research and tell you guys about it, but obviously caused an allergic reaction, and now I'm swollen, looking crazy. But it's fine. It's not itchy, burning, like, no, you know, it doesn't feel grainy in my eye. It doesn't feel like an infection. It really doesn't feel that uncomfortable. Except that my eye feels heavy, but on this side especially. This side feels fine. This side just feels a little heavier, and then my brows are a little itchy, but just a little bit. If I leave them alone, I don't really feel it. So it's not as bad as it looks. It just, it's annoying, but not like really, really irritating, thankfully. All right, guys, so this is the check-in for day four. If you hear my AC, I am sorry for the background noise, but it is hot and I'm not trying to sweat because I'm about to jump on a flight and we're not gonna try to get sweaty and sticky before the flight. But I wanted to show you what the results are. So yesterday I went to urgent care and I received a steroid shot in my butt. They asked me if I wanted a steroid shot and I was like, yeah, thank you so much. Because I have a flight tomorrow and I'm going to be international for over 10 days. So I'm gonna need, you know what I'm saying? Speed of recovery, please. So I got a steroid shot. That thing hurt in my butt. Like, when they give you a shot in your butt, it's not supposed to hurt as bad because it's like fatty back there, but whoo, it hurt, all right? It's not too bad, but I'm a little sore. Anyway, they did that, and I also got oral steroid medication, which is prednisone. My mom was like, don't take that. Oh my God, it's gonna blow you up. Oh my God. And I'm like, do I wanna put on weight or do I wanna keep this swelling? Like, let's choose, okay? Choose a battle. And it's only a 4-day dosage, so it's not like a big deal. It's just to get the swelling down. And they said, once everything is back to normal, I can stop. So I took my first dose last night. I haven't taken my second dose yet.
So it looks pretty good now. I'm gonna monitor it. If it looks good tomorrow, I can just stop taking the prednisone. But they also said I should take Zyrtec. So I have Zyrtec stacked in my carry-on, ready to go. But the swelling has definitely gone down. This eye was the really bad one, and it's not as bad anymore. Actually, low-key, I kind of like it because it kind of evened out my eyelid space. So this eye was more hooded than this one, and now I have a defined lid. It's kind of weird, like it evened out my eyes. Let me try henna every day to do that, right? No, I'm not gonna do that. But yeah, my eyes are definitely going down in swelling. The brows are still a little bit itchy. So I'm gonna bring this face roller to just cool the area. I'm just gonna put it in my pocket because, listen, it is very soothing and it's the coldest one I have. I tried all my other ones and this one gets the coldest. So I'm just gonna toss this in my carry-on as well so I can rub over my brows. But let me tell you, the brows look good, okay? And I am really going to try to find another brow tint that doesn't contain henna because I think henna is the problem here. So I'm just gonna find another brow tint and do this again because I really like the ease of it, the result. Like, this looks good. Like, I'm doing nothing to my brows for this flight. I put on some eyeshadow primer so my lids don't get really greasy. I want it, ooh, this Tarte Roller also feels good, but it's bigger, so I'm not gonna take that one. But I'm just gonna pop on mascara and be on my flight. Like, stop playing with me. I don't wear makeup on flights. I think my skin looks pretty good without makeup, so I'm not worried about my skin. I'll put on a little moisturizer, and I have my travel moisturizer in my carry-on because, you know, the plane does dehydrate the skin, so drink your water. And I'm going on 2 10-hour flights, so yeah, I'm gonna need help with my skin. I have my lip balm, but yeah, that's the update for day 4. I don't think I need to check in for day 5 because the swelling is going down. So if it gets worse, I'll let you know. But I'll just wrap up in the outro with what happened over the next few days. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Before you guys say anything, all right? Listen, all right? It's fine. Everything is fine. I am completely recovered, as you can tell. But it was quite a journey, and I am so happy I filmed like the whole process so I could warn you guys about not using henna on your brows, okay? And here's the thing, I can't blame the actual product because reading is fundamental. It clearly says on this box that I happen to not read at all. Like, I read the instructions inside the box, so I already showed you what this is. This is from Parallel Products. Again, not bashing the actual product because I think it's a great product to use for your hair. I might even want to try to use it on my grays, but I don't care about grays so much. But it's a great little touch-up product, right? I didn't realize that this was not meant to be used on your brows, and they say it clearly, okay? But me, Miss Ma'am, did not read that, okay? I read the little insert because I'm like, the insert should tell me everything I need to know, right? No, there's also information on the box. So it literally says on the box, right? Caution: this product contains ingredients which may cause skin irritation on certain individuals, and a preliminary test according to accompanying, I can't pronounce that word, oh my god, why is that word so difficult? Accompanying. Hold on. No. Accompanying. Why was that word so hard? Accompanying. What a weird word. I never realized how weird that word was to say out loud. Anyway, accompanying. See, I still can't say it. Oh my god. A preliminary test according to accompanying directions should first be made. Obviously, this product must not be used for dyeing the eyelashes or eyebrows. To do so may cause blindness.
Y'all, they done told me this product must not be used for dyeing the lashes and brows. And that is exactly what I did. And the damn thing says it may cause blindness. Like, are we serious? Are we serious? Warning for cosmetic use of hair coloring only. Do not use in the area of the eye. Do not use on cut or abraded scalp. Well, I didn't use it on my scalp. But it's like, it's warning me here not to use it on my brows or near my eye. But what did I do? What did I do? Put it on my brows. Put it on my brows. And let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. The color, the results were beautiful, okay? If you guys have a recommendation for a product that would do the same thing, mind you, okay, I already went ahead and bought other brow tint products to try out, which I will try out and let you guys know how it goes. If that interests you, let me know in the comments below, because I will, you guys, if you wanna go on that journey with me, then come along, because I really loved the results, okay? They kind of faded out pretty quickly because I was constantly rubbing them, right? I was rubbing them with Aquaphor and Neosporin and Benadryl. It was a whole situation and I was trying to get the product off. So it obviously faded pretty quickly, but for what it was worth, it was a beautiful color and I really loved the results. You saw that I loved the results. So I do want to try to tint my brows again and see if I can get a product that would actually stay a little bit better and not try to kill me, okay? So you wanna take that journey with me, let me know, but don't get this product and use it on your brows. Don't use it anywhere near your eyes. Don't do it, okay? Do not do it. If you're gonna use it in your hair, I actually do like it for that, but warning, do not use this product on your eyes. Learn from me, okay? But yeah. I'm glad that you guys were able to witness the torture that I endured, because it was quite an event, and right before vacation at that, oh my god, I was about to go on a 2-week trip and that happened. Can you imagine how crazy that was? And thankfully I was able to get that steroid shot at urgent care, because it started working almost immediately. I filmed right after I left urgent care, so just right after I got the shot, you saw how swollen I was, and then I went and picked up my prescription and the swelling already started going down, so I was very happy about that. As for the oral steroids, I ended up only taking like 2 of them because the urgent care nurse told me that I could stop once the swelling started to go down, like I didn't have to finish the full course. It's not like antibiotics, like you have to run the full course even if you're feeling better. She said once you get the results, just go ahead and, you know, discard the rest. So I only took 2 of those and everything is back to normal, okay? I am very happy. I'm a little bit nervous about putting eyeshadow on. This is the first time like I'm putting lashes on. It was a whole situation, but here we are. Yes, I survived it. So again, let me know if you want to take the brow tinting journey with me and if you have any recommendations. Again, I already picked up a brow tint that I'm going to try, but if you have recommendations, leave them down below. Make sure they're not henna, and I will go ahead and leave my Instagram and Twitter where you should be following me along, okay? Because if you followed me along on Instagram, you already saw the fiasco. You already got a preview of this video. So make sure you're following me along. And until my next video, which will be very soon, I'll talk to you. Bye, guys.